I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for tuning in to another guitar lesson. This week, I had a question sent to me from Miguel out in Colombia, and he wrote in saying, I was wondering what I can do to incorporate quartal arpeggios. This alternative to triads of building stacked fourths seems really interesting to me, but I can't seem to have any success making a song up using this approach. Maybe I'm going at it all wrong, so I'm wondering if you might be able to go through quartal arpeggios and harmony. And that was from Miguel in Colombia. So thanks for writing in, Miguel. You know, in songwriting or improvisation, we can experience a very fresh effect by introducing a new vocabulary, such as quartal harmony or quartal arpeggios. Now, obviously, this breaks away from the very common stacked third sound that we experience most often in music. And when we begin looking at alternatives like stacked fourths, many times students will experience difficulty with controlling these new sounds. So let's begin our lesson on quartal arpeggios by checking out this unique sound and learning how to practice it on the guitar. In discussing quartal arpeggios, let's start with the harmony, and I'd like to go off of a D and give you an idea of stacking some fourths together to create a harmony off of D. And basically what we have there is we're traveling a fourth from the D to a G, a fourth from the G up to a C, and then a fourth from the C to an F, and we're building an interval design of a fourth away, giving us an 11th or fourth degree, and then the C note acts as a flat 7, and then the F will obviously act as sort of a minor third, so the color here is basically like a minor 11th color. Let's do this in one more area off of the fourth string. We'll take an A note, and we'll just come up from A in fourths. We'll have A to D. The D would go to a G. The G would travel to a C. And so we would have the same interval design, root fourth or 11th, and flat 7 and minor third. So again, the color is that of minor 11. The root is A, so it's like an A minor 11 idea. So there's a couple of shapes to get you started for some harmony. But let's go over into stacking these ideas and stacking fourths basically in a position. I'm going to take you over to the third position off of a G, and we'll go fourths away from that G in the bass. So we'll have G to C to F, then we'll go upwards from the G now, sorry, the C now, and we'll go C to F to B flat, and then we'll have the F to the B flat to an E flat, and then B flat to E flat to A flat. So that's all in position off that G there. And that's an example of stacked fourths in a position. I'd like to go over yet one more idea, and this is an idea you can use to track chords if you'd like. We're going to go to an A this time on the sixth string, and we're going to use fourths off that A, so we'll go A to D to G. Then we're going to go out a fifth from that A. We're going to travel to E now and do some fourths off E. We'll have E to A to D. Then from that E, we'll go out a minor third, and we'll take things from a G note, and we'll go G to C to F. And from that G now, we'll go out a perfect fifth, and we'll go from D, having D to G to C. So all together, we have the A root. Then we'll go to the E root. Then we'll head to the G root. And then we'll head to the D root. So it's a really interesting combination, and it's tracking the intervals off of each root. And you can do that all over the fingerboard. You could stick with one interval. You know, you could try doing a bunch of minor thirds. You could try doing all perfect fifths. You know, you could try mixing them up like I did here. You can try incorporating it in some melodies. You can take it into some improvisation. But I think between some of the examples I've shown you here, plus the melody that I put together for the outset of the video that you had a chance to hear me play there, I think between those two ideas, you should be able to have enough going where you can start taking it into your own direction with these quartal arpeggios and some of the quartal harmony I discussed to begin implementing it in your own playing. Whenever any of my students will get interested in unique harmonic ideas, like Quartal Harmony or Quartal Arpeggios, I always suggest that they break these unique sounds into small parts and work over limited sets of chord changes. It's by far the fastest way to adding new ideas into one's playing. And by targeting the shapes of the intervals in a few limited areas of the neck, you'll gain a much faster understanding of how the idea will work across the entire fingerboard. So the trick is knowing where you're going with any new concepts, interval combinations, before you jump around the fingerboard with any attempts at composing or improvisation. Anyway, thanks for watching. Have fun working on this stuff. You can download the handout and MP3 jam track for this lesson over at my website at andrewwasson.com. And you can follow me on Twitter, through Facebook, and on my other guitar blog YouTube channel, as well as on my weekly podcasts that come out every Monday. The links are all in the description box below. Take care, everybody, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.